It's Explain, a podcast where... Oh my god, I can't do it today. I can't.
Hello. Hi, I'm Amanda, and she's also Amanda, and welcome to Idiots Explain, the podcast where one Amanda will hopefully speak to the other Amanda about something she likes, while the other Amanda just... I don't know what's happening anymore,
I'm
people.
I'm dead. I'm deceased.
Guys, we're just dead. Okay.
Is that the start?
Yes, it's the start. We're doing this. We're in.
We're here. Okay, today I'm very tired.
We're tired.
I'm so tired today.
I can't tell if like we're up on the caffeine or if we're coming down. Guys, buckle your seatbelts.
I'm both at the same time.
Because we're like on a high point right now. By the time this is over, we're gonna be like, we're just okay. Grievous, indulge me. What are you doing? Okay. What is happening today?
So today, I have a question for you.
Okay.
How familiar are you with international teen dramas?
What?
Teen dramas not from America. Are you familiar?
Please tell me, are we doing like some Mexican soap opera?
No, we're not.
What are we doing? I don't know. I don't know.
Today we're talking about the Norwegian teen drama Skam.
Okay, fine.
Yes, that's what I've chosen today.
Okay, cool.
Skam. What? S-K-A-M. Means shame in Norwegian.
Have you ever heard of these things? How do you find these things? Where do you go at 3 o'clock in the morning to where you find Norwegian teen drama? Is this like a reality show?
No, it's not.
What is it? Is it like Degrassi or whatever?
Did you ever watch Skins? There was a UK version and an American version. But I heard the American version wasn't good.
The only thing that's coming to mind is Skin Wars, the makeup, the...
No.
Which is amazing, by the way. Those people are freaking nuts.
Oh, no, they're amazing.
Yeah.
Okay. I was kind of banking on hoping you knew or you had seen Skins.
No.
Dang.
Sorry.
It's okay.
Wait, is it a plastic surgery show?
No.
Not a clue.
It's another teen drama.
No, teen dramas, Grievous, teen dramas are not really my thing. I didn't even watch Glee. I never watched Secret Life of American Teenager.
I watched both of those.
That was not my bag. That was not my bag. Okay. I was more of a Doctor Who, Sherlock.
I was all of the above.
Intelligent shows, I like to tell myself.
Uh-huh.
Or children's shows, like cartoons. But yeah.
Yes.
Skam, Norwegian.
Teen drama.
Okay.
Okay, so the reason why I was kind of hoping... that you knew what Skins was because it has a very similar format.
Okay.
Where each season, there's a different main character.
Okay.
So, like, each season's from the perspective of a different character, but in, like, the same kind of friend group.
All right.
Yes. And so... Well,
that actually sounds very interesting.
It's very interesting.
Because then I feel like... I've never... I'm looking at it right now, and I have no idea. Not a freaking
I know season clue. 2 of Skins got really popular. I was more season 1 Skins.
Where was this on? Was it on, like...
It's online. It got really popular, though. There's an American version. I heard it was not good.
UK version, honestly, is usually better.
Yeah, except, personally, did you watch... You know Who's Line.
Of course I know Who's Line. Buddy, I do improv comedy.
I know. I was just saying. Yes. I personally like the U.S. Who's Line better than the British.
Oh, hell yeah.
Okay. Like, that's hell one.
Yeah. That's one. No.
The U.S. version of a different show. Damn it. I forgot.
The Office?
No. I never watched The Office.
Okay.
No.
At least it's in, like, with a Taz thing where it's like you forgot Killian's goddamn name. How dare you?
I was also very tired and I had lost my voice.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you did lose your voice for that one. Holy
I
crap.
Did. That was a fucking night. Okay, but back.
That night changed my life.
It did.
Okay, we gotta stop talking about Taz. Okay. Go watch Taz right now. It has almost
Go
like
listen to
views.
Taz.
Go make it 200 views on YouTube.
Please.
We're so close.
Okay, but yes.
Skam.
Skam is a Norwegian teen drama. Produced by NRK, which is like a studio. A studio in Norwegian. Created by Julie Andem, who's like...
I was so hoping you were going to say Julie Andrews right there. I was going to go, time out! What is she doing in Norwegia? What was she doing in Normandy? Bless you, Dane Julie Andrews. She's Dane? Is she ordained? Not ordained.
Yeah, she's a Dane.
Sorry, guys. I just got engaged, so ordained and marriage stuff is on my brain right now. I'm sorry.
Yep. No, so Julie Andem, who is the creator of this.
And okay.
So one special thing about Skam that I think got people really hooked on it.
Okay.
It is a multimedia show.
What does that mean?
So, every week...
like on TV or online or on...
Yeah. Okay. So every week there is like an episode on TV.
Okay.
But you... They have a website for it, which on the website, every day you get something. So you get a clip, a text, or an Instagram.
That sounds very... Oh, God. Not connected. Hands-on?
Yeah.
There's another word.
No, I get what you mean.
Interactive?
Yes, it's very interactive.
Yeah.
But yeah, and you can actually follow the characters on Instagram.
That sounds like every Tumblr show's dream. Like, if Supernatural were to do that, it would go for even longer, and it's already on its 14th season. It's like, why?
It needs to stop.
It needs to stop. S-K-A-M.
No, we're not there yet!
Okay, fine! I was just looking up stuff, but apparently... Oh, yeah, because that's not what we do.
That's not what we do!
Guys, we're super not focused today.
No, this is a bad day. I was like, I'm going to do minimal notes and we're just going to have a breezy episode.
Oh, we're having a breezy episode. We're just like, forget this.
But yeah, so multimedia show. There is a website where you could follow along for every season.
Cool.
And you can follow them on Instagram, all that fun stuff. But yeah, I think that's what people really liked about it.
Yeah.
And so when it first premiered, it was obviously in Norway and all of Scandinavia, including Denmark.
Okay.
And apparently people in Denmark loved it.
All right.
But yeah, it got really big on Tumblr. No surprise.
No duh.
That's how I found out about it.
Tumblr's usually...
how I find out about most things.
Dude, Supernatural, Doctor Who, Sherlock. Yeah. I found out about Hamilton through Tumblr. I'm like, what the hell
really?
Is this?
Nice.
It's like, this is stupid. It's like, what kind of stuff is this? With Alexander
What's
Hamilton.
This? What's this?
There's color everywhere.
Okay, so Skam has 4 seasons, which we thought there was going to be more.
Okay. Oh, it's over?
It's over.
Oh.
Yeah. It's over. So they start in their, like, freshman year of high school.
Okay.
But we don't make it to their last. So I think there's, like, 3 years of high school, and we don't make it to their last year.
Why? Senior year is where all the drama happens.
What I heard happened is there got a lot of pressure, and they didn't want to have to keep up with it. And so they wanted to end on a certain note.
I can understand that.
Yeah, because they had plans for more, and they're like, no, we're going to end it here.
I can appreciate that. I feel like Sherlock should have done that.
Yeah.
Instead of, freak, I can't. I'm done. Okay, we're not going to get into that.
Yeah, because so there's 4 seasons, but season 3 is where Skam got really popular. Mm-hmm. Like, it popped off for Skam in their 3rd season. Even so much that, like, that's when, like, Americans, I would say, it got into, like, American media a little bit.
Uh-huh.
E! Online, they had a poll on, like, best couple of the year. And, like, the couple from season 3 of Skam won.
Oh, wow. Okay.
An American E! Online poll.
All right.
Season 3 is where they got international fan base, and they couldn't keep up with all the demands and all the viewership and all everything.
So they're just like, we're out!
Yeah. Now we have that kind of backstory to it. Let's talk about what it is.
Yes, please.
So it takes place at a Norwegian high school, like a real one.
Yeah.
And the characters are played by actual teenagers.
Oh, thank God. Instead of, like, 30-year-olds who are playing to be...
Yeah, I would say they're all, like... They started, like, 16 to, like, 21, where it's, like, the age range of the actors.
Yeah.
Maybe a little older for... Because they had a few characters who were out of, like, in college mm-hmm. age.
Yeah.
But everyone was around the age they're supposed to be. They had acne. There was, like, people who were, like, overweight.
Wait, time out. Are we talking about, like, real problems here?
Yeah.
Whoa!
So it's supposed to be about, like, real problems. Like, real teen life.
Relatable.
Yeah, it's supposed to be very relatable.
What a concept!
There's, like, two. There's, like, the girl squad and the boy squad. And one of the guys on the boy squad has, like, very visible acne.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not covered up. Like, everyone, like, it's not, like, totally made up in, like, So it's really nice. A few of the boys on the boy squad actually went to the school they filmed at.
Wow.
Yeah, which I think was Hartford Neeson. It's the school that they filmed at.
Okay.
Fun fact.
Okay.
But yeah, so season 1 starts off with the formation of the girl squad.
Okay.
And I also want to say that I've heard from Julie Annam, the creator, that this whole, like, series was kind of about one relationship and just, like, everything around that relationship. Which the relationship it's around it, it's, like, the season 2 relationship,
mm-hmm.
which not a lot of people... It's not their favorite.
Okay.
But we'll get to that. I just also want to put that down.
Fine.
Yes. And this is the point where I'm talking, and I'm going to forget every single name of every character.
That's fine.
Yes. Oh, golly, jeez.
Oh, golly, gee. Well, gee willikers, Grievous. Jeez, we've got ourselves in a bit of a conundrum here, don't we?
Yeah. That's how I talk. Don't make fun of me.
That's one of my favorite characters if I'm doing improv and I'm doing a child. I just go into, like, some, oh my God. What the hell is your name? Judy Garland?
Yeah, Judy Garland.
Judy Garland from Wizard of Oz. I'm just like, oh, no, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to do that. Well, golly gee willikers, Mr. Williams, I'm awful sorry about all this.
That's just how I talk in my day-to-day life. Okay, yeah, so season one, to get back on track, is about Eva.
They're Norwegian names.
Yeah, Eva, I believe is how they say it.
I will forgive you for calling them something else.
Yeah. I did try to brush up on my Norwegian.
The two people that are listening right now that actually know what you're talking about, they will have pitchforks and whatever, but...
My apologies. But yeah, so Eva, who... So we're introduced to her and her boyfriend, Jonas.
Ooh, okay.
Yes. And we learn that Eva has recently lost her friend group.
Oh.
So she's kind of friendless. Her best friends are her boyfriend, Jonas, and his best friend slash her friend, Isaac.
These are cool names.
Yeah. Which everyone, I just called him Isaac, because it's I-S-A-K.
Isaac.
Okay. Isaac. But yeah. And so those are kind of her only friends. And we've kind of, to spoil like the season, we find out her friends left her because one of her best friends was dating Jonas, and then she kind of stole Jonas.
Oh my God. Drama! From
her. And so she kind of lost all of her friends. And so season one's really about like friendship and being true to yourself, mm-hmm. and how, like, listening to your own things.
True to your heart.
So it's about, like, this girl who's, like, just trying to find, like, a new friend group and trying to connect with people.
Yeah.
And that's kind of where the formation of the girl squad comes in. And so it's, like, so it's Eva, Nora, Vilda, Chris, and Sana. It's the girl squad.
Sana.
Cool. Sana. Yes, who is a Muslim girl.
Okay.
Which, that'll play a bigger part later. Sana ends up getting her own season.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. And so, a bunch of white girls, and then a Muslim girl. Which is fine.
Yeah.
There are a lot of big characters. So, Nora is kind of that girl, that feminist stereotype kind of girl. Mm-hmm. Eva's just, like, the normal kind of relatable girl. Chris is, like, the funny one. Vilda is, like, that girl who really wants to be popular. She wants to be in the in crowd. And they kind of are like, no, you're too much.
Yeah.
And then Sana is just like, she's a Muslim girl in a faithless country, as she says.
All right.
She's the biggest loser of them all.
Aw, Sana, no.
But Sana's a very take-charge attitude. Love and her. They're trying to plan this whole, like, there's like a party bus thing in like Norwegian high schools where there's like a bus system.
What? Okay.
Yeah, I forget. I think it's called like Rusentid. Yeah, so like all the cool kids get like a bus and they have like a party bus. And,
okay.
Like, that they, like, buy and they have part. Like, that's all, the, like, a cool kid thing. And they want to start their own, like, bus and be the cool girls.
Okay.
So that's kind of the whole start of this. Which is kind of why it was so...
Like, they buy their own...
You have to buy a bus. Like, a party bus.
Just, like, that they have that is their own...
Yes! And you see that in season two. So there's a
group... So, like, we get individual cars.
Yeah.
They get party buses.
Yeah. Well, it's, like, a group thing.
Oh.
That, like, and they get... And groups get sponsorships to do this.
Okay, whatever.
Yeah,
this like, is Nor. This I, what do I keep wanting to call it? Norwegia.
Norwegia.
It's not Norway.
Norway.
It was like Norga. It was like back in the 10th grade when I asked, "What do they speak in Switzerland? Do they speak Switzy?"
Fun times.
Oh, super happy fun times.
But yeah, so like the popular boys in school, I forget if they're like a basketball team or they're just like a group of popular guys. They're called the Penetrators.
God damn it, people.
And they have hoodies with all their names on it that say the Penetrators. And they, in season two, we see they have their own party bus where, like, they go and they party in it with the girls.
Okay.
But that's, like, the popular boys.
The chicks are cream. Go, go for Greaseland. Go, go, go.
And there's a, so, like, the two guys from the Penetrators who, like, make an appearance are William and Chris. So you see, there's two Chris's. There's girl Chris and boy Chris.
Okay.
And boy Chris is normally called P. Chris. Because Penetrator Chris.
Okay.
Who, kind of a douche nozzle. Both kind of a douche nozzle.
Really? In a group called the Penetrators?
Yeah. There's a whole thing in, like, season one where, like, so the Penetrators have hoodies. And, like, every girl they sleep with, they'll give them their hoodie with, like, their name blacked out. So you kind of know who they slept with. Which is super grody.
Yeah.
But slightly. It's, like, they're the popular boys. And Vilda wants to sleep with William so bad.
Part of me really wants to ask, what color are the sweatshirts tan?
They're black.
And it's, like, on the hoodie, is there just, like, an accentuated, like, white, like, line
no.
down the center of it?
Okay. I'll show you. But yeah, so those are kind of like the popular boys, and Vilda really wants to sleep with William because he's like the hottest, most popular boy.
Yeah.
And like, she ends up doing so.
Okay.
And she's like, oh, it's so magical, so fresh, so fun. And then he acts like he never saw her.
Yeah.
It's one of those moments, but it's about kind of Eva dealing with her relationship and her new friends. And she kind of falls into this thing where she thinks Jonas is talking to his ex-girlfriend, her ex-best friend.
Okay.
And she kind of, like, sees that they have, like, a text from her and that, like, he cheated on her, all this stuff. And it kind of culminates into this, like, Halloween party where she kind of, as they say, hooks up, like, with P. Chris.
Mm-hmm.
So they call hooking up just, like, kissing.
Oh.
So it's like, oh, they're hooking. They're, like,
the snuggie.
Making out. Yeah.
Yeah.
Which I was like, wait, so you hooked up, you had sex? No, you just kissed him. Why do you keep saying you hooked up with him? But then, like, that kind of comes out, and so there's, like, relationship drama with them. And it turns out he wasn't really cheating on her. It turns out his ex-girlfriend's brother is his weed guy. So he was, like, talking to her to get to, you know.
Relationships are funny.
Yeah, but there's so a lot of tension between, like, Eva and Jonas and Isaac, who's, like, both of their friends.
Yeah, so he's caught in the middle. And
he's caught in the middle.
Ah!
So, yeah, so there's a lot of friction between. So she thinks Jonas is hooking up with his ex, so she kind of actually, not accidentally, but she is, like, very emotional about it. It's kind of crying in a bedroom at a party.
Of course.
P. Chris comes in, tries to console her.
Okay.
They kiss and
of
all
course.
That stuff. Then she finds out P. Chris has a girlfriend.
I'm finding there to be a lot of typical
yeah.
drama.
Yeah, typical teenage drama. The season ends with, like, Eva deciding, you know what? She is taking other people's opinions too much into account, and she needs to learn how to take her own opinion into account. That's kind of how the season concludes after all this drama, and she finds out kind of Isaac, who she confided all this into, told people, and that's how Jonas found out, and she confronts Isaac about it, and he's like, it's just because, like, I was jealous because I have a crush on you.
Mm-hmm. Oh, God.
And she was like, what?
Why?
But then we find out at the very last episode, the very last clip of the season, like I said, these are kind of brought out in clips.
Mm-hmm. And there's texting and stuff going on behind the scenes. Oh, this is fascinating.
Yeah, so it's only from Eva's perspective. So you only see Eva's texts.
Okay.
You see all the characters, like, Instagrams, but you only see her text, and then all the clips are from her perspective.
Sweet.
Yeah.
This is fascinating.
Yes, it's very interesting.
Almost like a character study, if you will.
Yeah.
This is amazing.
No, I'll get into this later when we talk about season 3.
Okay.
Because there's, like, character study, or people, like, do characters about Jonas in particular. Because he never gets his own season,
uh-huh. But
he's a main character in season 1 and 3.
Okay, coming back to it really quick. Jonas is her boyfriend.
Okay.
Yes. And Isaac's best friend.
Isaac.
Isaac, you know.
Yes.
Well, you said it earlier. Okay.
I did. So, she comes from, Isaac says, I have a crush on you. The last clip of the season, Nora borrows Isaac's phone because hers died, and so did Eva's. And for some reason, she goes into his, like, internet to do something.
Yeah.
And finds a bunch of gay porn on Isaac's phone. And then they're like, wait a sec. And then they look over and we see Isaac giving Jonas googly eyes. And so they're like, no.
Oh, the drama.
The drama.
Oh my God.
And that's how the season concludes.
See, like, I always wonder, like, do people have this much drama in real life?
No. I think the most is, like, I had a friend who, she dated a guy for, like, I want to say a month or two.
Okay.
Freshman year, and then sophomore year, a different friend of ours dated the same guy, but didn't tell anyone, and it kind of was, like, secret until we all realized.
And, yeah.
Yeah, and then that was kind of drama, and then my friend who dated him before convinced our other friend to break up with him outside of Yogurtland.
Oh, jeez.
And then we went.
Was it the one outside of, like, by Northwood Pizza?
Yeah.
Oh, bless. Oh, my God.
That's the biggest drama I think I had. Or I feel like I always heard about drama. I just didn't care.
It's too much.
We
had enough to stress about in high school. It's like,
yeah.
This, I don't need this.
I feel like there was drama adjacent to me, especially in color guard.
I took drama in class. I didn't need any more. Okay.
Right.
But season 2, I'm actually very fascinated by this.
Yeah, I feel like it's a very fascinating series, but it's hard to watch.
Why?
Because.
Acting?
No. Acting's amazing. The reason why it's hard to watch is because it was hard to find. It became known as...
Oh, it was just difficult to...
To find, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Because, so they became known as the Google Drive fandom. Because you literally had to find the Google Drives that had the episodes that were subtitles.
Oh, okay.
And watch it through that.
All right.
Yeah.
cool.
Yeah, it's fun.
Okay, because I was, it's like difficult to watch. I'm like, oh God, is it really just that cringy? Or it's just,
the acting's great. Like, I know the guy who plays Isaac was nominated for an award because of his acting.
It's a quality show. It's a quality show. Difficult to find.
It's difficult. Now it's easier because it's so popular.
Of course.
So you can definitely find master lists of everything that like tell you where to find everything. I think I actually have like one saved on my laptop. But yeah, so season two, the main character for season two is Nora.
All right.
Eva's best friend.
Okay.
The girl who had Isaac's phone.
Yeah.
So Nora was kind of, in season one, we find out she recently moved back to Norway from Spain. And so she didn't have any friends. So that's why she kind of like joined, like became friends with Eva, joined the girl group, very feminist person. Mm-hmm. And in season one, we see her kind of have this confrontation with William. Or she will say Wilhelm, because she just says his name wrong, because he's an asshat.
Okay.
And he is. He's, like, such a douchebag. I hate him. And basically, she, like, confronts him and basically says he's pathetic, this whole thing, this whole rant at him, which is, like, one of the iconic scenes from, like, season one.
All right.
But he kind of decides, I like her, and I'm going to pursue her.
Okay, great.
To the point where it's, like, she says no so many times, but he just keeps going.
It's like, take the goddamn hint.
Yeah. And he even, so if you remember, William is the guy Vilda slept with.
Yeah.
Who kind of broke her heart. Yeah. But at the end of the season one, he kind of goes up and apologizes to her and says she didn't deserve that.
Good for him.
But uses kind of Vilda to get to Nora.
Right.
Because he knows Vilda likes him and he knows she can use Vilda to get to Nora.
Oh my God.
So yeah. So beginning of season two, we kind of find out that he somehow gets Nora's number and he's texting her, bothering her, using Vilda to get to her and all that stuff.
Guys are dumb.
Yeah. And so she finally agrees to go on a date with him.
Just to say, shut up.
Yeah, like, I did it. Stop it.
Mm-hmm.
And she's just the moodiest girl, like, not putting up with his crap, not listening to his sob story.
Spoil it for me now. Do they end up with...
Yes! They end up together.
Is it at least realistic?
So, the thing is, I dislike this couple the most. And I feel like a lot of people also dislike it a lot.
Yeah.
Because we're introduced to Nora as this feminist girl who has, like, all these beliefs. And it feels like her relationship with William compromises a lot of those.
Yeah.
And so a lot of people kind of see him as a compromise to her character.
Yeah. I mean, and that's not the first time we've seen that.
No,
ever.
Yeah. And like I was saying before, how, like, Julie kind of had this one couple and the whole kind of thing is centered around that one couple.
Yeah.
This is the couple. She, like, loves Nora. Like, that's her, the base character for this whole season.
Okay.
Because Nora plays a big part in every season, no matter who the main is. And so, this is my least favorite season. It's also the longest season.
Oh, okay.
So, you kind of just see them, like, slowly getting together.
Yay.
Him kind of being, like, vulnerable and her, like, slowly falling for him. But, like, he's a bad boy. Because, if you remember, he's part of the Penetrators, the big popular boys.
Is there any more to the season than this?
There's, like, a big... So, there's one scene where they go to, like, the girl squad goes to the Penetrators party bus to party. And then a fight breaks out.
Like, it does.
Yeah, and, like, William's kind of, like, a main person in that fight. And there's a whole thing with, like, cops. And all this deal and how Nora's like, oh, you shouldn't use violence to treat violence. All this stuff. And he's like, well, like, what do you want to, like, do? And, like, kind of belittling her beliefs.
Yeah.
And it's just, like, she just takes it, almost. Yeah.
Rolling my eyes so hard right now.
But she, like, does so much to try to help, and it's just, like, it's not cute. And then, like, he's gonna, I forget what, again, this is the season I've kind of taken the least amount of interest in.
Yeah.
Paid the least amount of attention to. But, so it kind of ends up where he decides he's gonna leave Norway and go live with his dad in England.
Go live in England anyway.
So he's gonna kind of leave their relationship. He's gonna go live in England and kind of just leaves her there, and she's very sad about it.
Of course.
But in general, they end up together.
Yeah.
He comes back, they get together, they have a party thing, they hook up. But a second layer to this season, which I think is one of the main kind of themes, is I talked about morals, but also like sexual abuse.
Oh, damn!
Yeah. So, Nora's like they're like 16.
Uh-huh.
I want to say William's like 17.
Okay.
I want to say he's a grade or two above them.
Okay.
And he kind of lives on his own. His parents are rich, but they're never around.
Yeah.
He's kind of one of those, like, has to, like, take care of himself. And we're introduced to his older brother, Nico. And he is a scummy dude. Like, Nico will kind of make you like William.
Oh, God.
Yeah, which William is, he's okay. He's just not, he's a teenager.
But compared to Nico, he's a knight in shining armor.
Yeah, Nico's kind of a manipulator. William doesn't like him. It's like, it's my brother. Like, what else am I going to do kind of stuff.
Yeah.
And so she meets Nico kind of after, like, by, like, accident at, like, William's apartment.
Mm-hmm.
And she comes, like, her phone is dead. And there's, like, a different time. She goes over to talk to William.
What happens? Just cut to it. What happens?
Okay. So, like, there's a party, and Nora, who doesn't drink.
Yeah.
She establishes that season one, she doesn't drink, she doesn't do anything. Goes to William's apartment, finds Nico having, like, a dinner party there.
Uh-huh.
Decides, she's very upset, she decides to drink. Drinks so much, she blacks out and doesn't remember anything.
Oh,
but
man.
She wakes up naked in bed.
Ah!
And we find out Nico took pictures of her naked and tells her, like, they
we did it.
They did stuff. And we also find out Nora, previously, she lost her virginity at 13, way too young, and she's kind of very scarred about that. And that's another reason why she doesn't drink.
Yeah.
And so she doesn't know what to do.
Yeah.
She doesn't know who to talk to. Finally, like, tells the girl squad. They kind of go, and they go to the nurse and all that stuff.
Yeah.
But William thinks she cheated on him with his brother.
Oh, my God.
And so he is a very big piss baby about it.
This sounds so soap opera-y.
I would say it's, like, the most soap opera-y out of all of the seasons.
Okay.
But she kind of head-to-head takes on Nico and, like, is like, oh, I'm going to take you to court. And he's like, what are you going to do to me? Like, you're just, like, some kid.
Yeah.
And Nora's very smart, though. She, like, meets up with him in, like, a cafe or something. Mm-hmm. And
records the whole thing.
Records the whole thing.
Of course.
And but she also knows, like, the laws. And she pulls up, like, receipts. And he's like, what are you going to do? And I'm like,
I'm going to do this. I'm going to do X, Y, and Z right
she's
now.
She's like, I'm recording this. And also, I still have those pictures you texted to me of me naked.
Yeah.
And he's, like, 19 or 20. He's, like, in his early 20s.
Yeah.
And she's like, I'm a minor. That's pedophilia.
Yeah.
And so she kind of gets even with him.
Yeah. Part of me, though, says you don't tell the guy who did this to you what you're gonna do, because...
Yeah, I can show you that scene, too. I'm kind of explaining it kind of bad.
Yeah, unless you say, I sent these to another person who you can't touch.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, she still has them. Like,
yeah.
I forget... I don't think he texted them to her. He might have messaged her on Facebook.
Okay.
Because that's the whole deal.
Yeah.
In, like, the seasons where Facebook plays a very big role.
Mm-hmm.
I never got on the Facebook scene, because I don't use Facebook. But apparently you could also, like, friend them and follow them on Facebook.
Weird. Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
I don't know. But yeah, so that kind of gets resolved, and it's a very, like, empowering moment.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of talk about sexual abuse in that.
Okay.
So, like, how season one was kind of about friendship, staying true to yourself, and believing in your own opinion.
Here, have this lighthearted, fluffy stuff to start off.
No, like, okay, normal
you're
teen
in,
drum.
You're in, here we go.
Yeah. Soap opera. Well, this one's more about kind of morals and, like, sexual abuse.
Yeah.
Kind of season.
All very real subjects.
Yes. But, I mean, we have a happy ending. They
of
have.
Course.
So, Nora doesn't live with her parents. I don't know if I mentioned that.
She what?
She doesn't live with her parents.
Hey,
so,
okay.
She lives on her own with roommates.
Okay.
And so those are, like, older roommates.
Yeah.
But they have, I just bring this up because they have, like, a party on the roof of their apartment.
Cool. Sounds fun.
With all the fun.
Cool.
People.
Yeah.
She lives with Lynn and Eskil.
Eskil. That's a cool name.
Yeah. Who I bring up with because they play a big part in season 3.
All right.
Eskil is, like, the gay best friend. He's very flamboyant, but I love Eskil. He's my fave. And season 3 is about Isaac. The only boy to get a season.
Okay.
And the theme for his, I'm just gonna put, is sexuality.
Cool.
Because again, season 1, we find out he's gay.
Yeah.
And there's actually a subplot in season 2 where they, like, Nora and Eva think P. Chris and Isaac are hooking up.
Yeah.
Because they, like...
With the gay porn and whatever.
Yeah. No, but, like, in season 2, so the gay porn on the phone was the end of season 1.
Yeah.
Season 2, we kind of see P. Chris and Isaac, like, make eye contact across the schoolyard, and Isaac just, like, does the call me sign, and they're like, what? And then there's another time where they see Isaac get into P. Chris's car and drive off.
Just like, ah!
They're like, something's going on with those two. To the point where, like, Nora's, like, talking to Eskil, like, hey, can you find out if this kid's gay? Like, on the low key, though? And, like, Eskil in season 2 is like, no, he's not gay. It's like, no, it's not.
Yeah.
Season 3 comes. We find out Isaac has Nora left to go live in England with William.
Oh, yay.
So that's, we find out
that's what that is.
That's what that is. And so Isaac moves into her old room. So now it's him, Eskil, and Lynn living in the apartment.
Yeah.
Or as a lot of, it's come to known as the collective. That's what their groomed chat is called. And we just see Isaac has a real hard time. So he kind of comes from His parents are separated, and we find out his mom is mentally ill.
Aye.
Because that's another theme of the season.
Wow.
Is homosexuality, or sexuality, and mental illness.
Wow.
Yes, and it's done very well. So we find out Isaac's mom is mentally ill, and...
Anything specific?
They never say... They do say, like, Isaac refers to her as being crazy, and that she kind of doesn't know what reality is, so I'm guessing some kind of schizophrenia.
That's what I was... Yeah.
So some sort of that, they never say.
Mm-hmm.
But she always sends him, like, Bible verses. He mentions that she thinks his uncle's Donald Trump. Like, just crazy stuff.
Yeah.
And we see her text Isaac throughout the season, just Bible verses. Just, like, a bunch.
Right.
Yeah, so Isaac's dad left them, and so he's kind of alone, having to deal with his mom at 16.
Mm-hmm.
And nobody knows this except Jonas, because Jonas is his best friend.
Yeah.
And they've been best friends for a while.
Yeah.
And so Isaac leaves to go in because he can't deal with it.
Yeah.
And so he has a very bad relationship with his parents.
As expected.
And so he has a hard time with that. And then he is slowly coming to terms with his sexuality, as cool. You do,
mm-hmm.
as like a 17-year-old. Because this is like their following year. So okay. I would say there's like 3 years of high school. So
yeah.
This is like their second year.
Okay.
Fun fact, in Norway, you don't go by like age or years. You go by like the year you were born.
Okay.
So there's like, oh, like I'm a 97 or like I'm a 99.
Sweet.
Yeah.
That actually seems slightly less complicated.
Right. So like, I think they have like grade levels,
yeah.
But they're like, oh, you're dating a 97 boy? Like, oh, like an older.
Dude, you're dating a 94 girl? What?
Yeah.
That actually sounds really cool.
Mm-hmm. So that's just like a fun tidbit about that. But yeah. So fun fact. So you remember how Eskil told Nora he's not gay?
Yeah.
Find out, Eskil found little baby Isaac
mm-hmm.
at a gay bar at like 2 a.m. and he didn't want to go home.
Oh.
And so Eskil brought him back to the collective
uh-huh.
and kind of let him live, like, I want to say in their like basement.
Yeah.
For a while, and was like taking just care of the baby.
Sleep on the couch. Yeah. Whatever. Yeah.
Eskil refers to himself as his guru. Was like, oh, I'm your guru.
Oh no.
And refers to Isaac as the baby gay.
I'm the gay roo.
The gay roo. But yeah, I love Eskil. He's very real and doesn't flower anything.
Mm-hmm.
But so yeah. So first like episode, we see Isaac kind of being established as like a playboy. Like he had a girlfriend in season 2. I think her name was Sarah. She was like one of Eva's ex-friends that she, at the end of season, they all became friends again.
Mm-hmm.
And so he's kind of established as a playboy. He's good with the ladies. And he starts dating this, or like not dating, but kind of starts flirting with this with this girl named Emma, who is a year younger. So she's a first year, he's a second year. I'm gonna say this is my favorite season. This is, I jumped into Skam season 3, because that's when it like blew up. Because
mm-hmm.
it's about the gays, and Tumblr loves the gays.
Tumblr does love the gays.
So yeah, so Isaac is established kind of as a playboy.
Okay.
And then he kind of, in the next episode, we see him just catch eyes with the new boy in town.
Oh.
Evan.
Of course it's Evan.
Evan.
It's always
spelled
Evan.
E-V-E-N. Like even. But it's Evan.
I will overlook this. I will get past this. Move on.
Which, when you're reading things,
makes it very interesting.
Yeah. So like, oh, Evan, even.
Even Evan.
Evan, the new kid in town. Grade higher than them. Find out he's repeating a year.
Ooh.
Yes. And he's just a hot new boy in town. And Isaac is intrigued. And he is intrigued by Isaac. We find out Evan actually spotted Isaac on the first day of school and was like, I want him. I must have him. But they kind of start...
I want to train you to be your...
Yeah, so they kind of start like a friendship kind of thing where like Evan kind of settles up and is like, I'm going to be friends with him. And they have like a weird kind of flirty hangout one day. Like, Isaac is like, hey, can you buy me and my friends beer? Evan's like, oh, I left my ID at home. Do you want to go to my apartment with me?
Yeah.
And they're like, sure. And they just end up, you know, sitting at Evan's apartment.
Yeah, I left my ID at home. Bring out the scissors. Do you want to go home to my apartment or something?
Yeah, what? And so they go back to Evan's place and they have a beer and smoke some weed.
Mm-hmm.
And just have talks and very cute, fun, fresh. And then Evan's like, oh. We hear someone come in through the door. He's like, oh, I forgot my friends are coming over. I hope that's okay. And he's just like, sure, that's fine. And he's sitting kind of just like...
Seductively.
Like a friend. Yeah. Like, he's like, oh, whatever, just me. And we are then introduced to Evan's girlfriend.
No.
Yes. Who, I forget her name.
It's fine.
Evan's girlfriend.
We'll just call her E.G.
E.G. No, because she plays a big part in the season. Okay, well, they don't list her on the fucking wiki, so.
E.G.
So, Evan's girlfriend. And Isaac's like, oh, crap, why did I kind of get up to this? He's not even out to anyone yet. Mm-hmm. But slowly, him and Evan kind of
hit it off,
and they have, like, a party, and there's, like, this one iconic scene. It's at Isaac's place. So, I forgot to mention, so, at the first party where Isaac established himself as a playboy, he is tasked with, like, hiding someone's weed. Mm-hmm. So, the boy squad, Isaac, Jonas, Magnus, and Madi. And so, Madi, he hides Madi's weed mm-hmm. at Eva's house.
Okay.
So, that's where the party is. And Sana finds it and kind of blackmails Isaac
yeah.
into joining kind of this theater thing. And
that's with, usually how you get people in.
Yeah, that's run by
join us!
Sana, Eva, and Vilda. Uh-huh. And then Vilda kind of like guilt trips Isaac into having a party for the theater thing at their place because she knows Eskil. And she's like, oh, Eskil said it was okay, so we can do it at your place.
Yeah.
Yeah, and so he's like, dang it. And so Evan and his girlfriend shows up. And Emma, the girl we're introduced to in the first season that Isaac's kind of flirting with.
Yeah.
And there's a scene on the dance floor where they're each dancing in their hetero couples. And they're, like, making out with the girls, but they have direct eye contact with each other.
Oh, my God.
There's so many good cinematic scenes in season 3.
That's really weird. Have you ever kissed anybody with your eyes open?
No.
It's a little weird.
I bet. Yeah, because it's like the girls are like into their own thing, and the boys are just like.
Like, I'm like.
They're like eye fucking each other.
Like,
hardcore.
This is for you. Like, this is for you.
Yeah.
Imagine, oh, that's weird.
Yeah, and then they somehow, like, end up doing, like, a Halloween date. Because, like, Evan's like, hey, you want to, like, hang out on Halloween? Or it's like, mm-hmm. you want to go to this party with me?
Yeah.
And then finds out it's, like, Isaac, Emma, Evan, and his girlfriend.
Oh.
And Isaac is, like, dressed up as Caesar, and Emma's Cleopatra. And then Evan's dressed up as God? I never get what his girlfriend is. I want to say probably, like, an angel or something.
Okay.
But, like,
Something couple-y.
Yeah, something couple-y. The two girls go off to do something. They're at someone's, like, house.
Yeah.
And then Evan, like, looks at Isaac, just goes, you want to leave? And he's like, yeah. And the next thing is them over, like, Evan's riding a bicycle and Isaac's kind of, like, on the back, like, and they end up at this house.
Yeah.
And Evan says, oh, this is my aunt's house. She has a pool. Let's go in, like, an indoor pool. So they sneak in.
Yeah.
And they have a very fun, kind of playful time in the pool.
I bet.
And they're like, let's see who can hold their breath the longest.
Oh, no.
And then they start making out underwater.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah, and then a little girl comes in.
Oh, no.
Screams for her mom.
Oh, no.
And Evan reveals that's not his aunt's house.
Oh, no.
That is a person he knew in elementary school's house.
Oh, no.
And so they're, like, soaking wet, and they have to, like, escape. But that is, like, their thing. And then the next scene, the next, like, clip, is them in Isaac's apartment just smoking weed and, like, making out and being really cute.
It's a fun night. Those are fun days.
Yeah. And so the rest of, like, their development is kind of, like, is Evan going to break up with his girlfriend? Is he in this? All this stuff.
Find out next week on Skam!
Yeah. Or find out tomorrow. Who knows?
Find out tomorrow!
Yeah.
Check online. Check your new local listings for Skam.
Yeah. So we kind of go through this rigmarole. Evan's like, I dumped her. Like, we're dating. Like, this is very serious.
Yeah.
And then there's one day, Evan rents them a hotel room.
Oh, boy.
In a very fancy suite.
Oh, boy.
And they do what a couple would do.
Oh, boy.
Yes. And that's the day where we find out that Evan is bipolar. He has manic, depressive, bipolar.
Anybody else feel the tension in the room? Just like we have this nice little thing going, and then all of a sudden it's just like, boom! Yeah.
And so he's kind of going, he's having a manic episode that day. So he's the highest of highs.
Okay.
And they're talking about something, and Evan's walking around the room naked, and then he's like, I'm going to get McDonald's. And he just leaves naked. And Isaac is freaking out.
Like,
he doesn't know what to do. He tries to chase after him. And he's like, he runs out, and then Evan's girlfriend shows up, like, I got him. He's, like, with his parents. This is why, like, I am the one who knows how to take care of him. I know.
Oh, no.
And, like, he doesn't love you. He's just manic. This has been a whole episode.
Oh, shit.
And that kind of just destroys
music. Oh, no.
And so he thinks this whole thing is just an episode that Evan doesn't really care about him and all this stuff.
See, it's like this, I find this to be very interesting, like, because I say it's like, oh, this is so soap opera-y, but then it's like you drop this into the mix, and it's not like, oh, this is just a complicated relationship. It's like, oh, shit, this is like some
And we find out, like, Evan had one of these at his old school, because I mentioned he's a transfer to Isaac school, and he had kind of a very manic episode, very public at his school, and he had to leave, go to another school, and repeat a year.
Wow.
Yeah.
Jeez.
And so, and we find out he's been dating his girlfriend for the whole time, so she's like, oh, only I know how to take care of him.
Yeah.
But he's like, no, she's just controlling, this is a relationship. So he's a, kind of believes his girlfriend for some reason. And we have, like, a scene where he's talking to Magnus, and we find out Magnus's mother is bipolar. And so he
Is happening?
Yeah. Well, it's very, like, casual. Because Magnus is kind of like the dumb kid.
Aw.
Like the dumb kind of funny character who has no game, but he really wants to hook up with a girl. So yeah, and it's very like, they're just at the lunch table and Magnus is telling, like, no, like, my mom's awesome. Like, you've seen her. And
it's just goes, like, yes. Yeah. It's like, people have bipolar. They can't like live normal lives.
Right. But Isa comes from knowing, like, his mom is like, that's crazy. And he also, there's a different scene where he tells Evan.
Wait, Isaac's mom is kind of, we'll say schizophrenic.
Yeah.
And he's dating a guy who is bipolar. And this guy, and Magnus is saying his mom is bipolar, and it's like, oh, no, she can live a normal life. But Isaac is seeing his mom.
And he says to Evan, before this whole, like, right when they're kind of getting together, he doesn't want to have to deal with, like, mentally.
No!
Because his mom has just been too much for him.
Oh,
so there's also that on Evan's mind, where now he knows. But Magnus is like, why are you listening to his girlfriend?
Yeah.
Have you talked to Evan about it? And he was like,
no.
You know what? No.
No, I haven't.
And so,
because he'd be cray-cray.
Yes. And this kind of culminates in a scene where Isaac is, like, going to church with his parents, which is a big thing. There's this whole
church. I'm sorry.
Where it's like, this is also in, like, December, so it's very kind of religion-y Christmas.
Uh-huh.
And there's this whole scene where him running from the church to the school, because Evan texts him, I'm at the place where we first met. Yeah. It's basically a goodbye letter.
No!
Basically telling him, I'm gonna kill myself.
Jesus!
Because it kind of goes from a high to a low. And he's in a depression.
Yeah.
And Isaac runs there, gets there, and he sees Evan alive. Fine. And they have this big moment where he tells him, you're not alone.
Aw.
And they kiss.
You are not alone.
Yeah.
Dear Evan Hansen, sorry.
And so they kind of...
This is still season 3, yes?
This is still season 3.
There's still a season 4, right?
There is.
Oh my god.
Okay, but yeah, so I'm giving a lot of love to season 3 because it's so good. And there's a lot of just visual goodness about it. Obviously, they end up together in the end. Going into season 4, we see they move in together.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just a gosh darn dang season. And I will show you more.
Yeah.
But going into season 4 is sauna season.
Okay.
And the theme is kind of religion. And not, and like, stereotype, but not, like, stereotyping.
Okay.
Because she's a Muslim girl.
Yeah.
But season 4, I think, had a hard time coming off of season 3. Because so many people loved it.
Yeah.
And season 4 just didn't bring it as hard, but I still loved it because I love Sana. She's a badass bitch.
It is very difficult to go from, like, bipolar and schizophrenia and mental illness to go into, like, religion.
Yeah.
Type of stuff.
Yeah. And so... Season 4 was good. I still liked it better than season 2.
Okay.
But I think what also brought it down was there's a reintroduction to the Nora-William relationship in season 4.
Why?
We kind of skipped out season 3 because Nora moved back and was like, I'm done. I can't deal with this.
Yeah.
But then there's a whole thing where William comes back season 4.
Oy.
So there's that whole thing. And I think season 4 just had a lot to deal with.
Yeah.
But still really good. And there's such a pure relationship. It's like the start. So it's Sana... and Yusuf.
Okay.
So Sana and Yusuf, they just have such a pure relationship, and it's so cute and fun, and, like, it's just dragged down by, like, teenage drama bullshit. I think that's the hard thing, is there's so many good moments in season 4,
mm-hmm.
and I'm not gonna go too much into detail, because I kind of was slowly losing interest in season 4, because I was also in my last year of college. My last semester.
I got shit to do.
Yeah.
This is not one of them.
So I think season 4 could have been so good, but they just tried to tie up too many loose ends. Because, like they said, Julie, I think, originally had 2 more seasons after that.
Yeah.
But they decided not to do them. And so Sana's season just got bogged down.
Aww.
With a bunch of stuff.
Yeah.
But it could have been so good. Okay. Yes. But this is going very long. And I'm going to show you some stuff.
All right.
And then we're going to do a little wrap-up.
Yay!
Yay!
God,
I mean, it's Norway. Oh, but
I know, but I forgot about that. I forgot like about that. But everybody is so pale, blonde, super skinny. They look like
everyone's skinny.
Most of them
though, are.
To be fair, we mostly just watched Evan and Isaac or
Isaac. Evan and Isaac.
We mainly just watched them.
I did show her some other stuff. But we're both tired.
Yeah.
I did not introduce you to the balloon boys.
Who cares? It was all
but
about...
But they're like, because that's from the 4th season with Sana, so that's all like the Middle Eastern boy squad.
Who cares? It's all about Evan and Isaac.
Isaac.
I keep wanting to go Evan and Isaac or whatever.
Yeah. Especially now that you've seen how I spelled it, you're like, yes.
Yes. Oh my God. Most of what we watched was just Evan and Isaac.
Because you demanded it.
I demanded it.
I showed her one clip and she was like, yes.
It's like, nope, this is the rest of the show.
I'm sold.
This is the rest of the show.
It's just, it's so good. And I feel like out of all 4 seasons, it's the most cinematically beautiful. It's just nice to look at.
It is.
So
many hot people. So many hot males.
But yes.
They're so foreign. No, they're so...
so foreign.
That's Fairly Godparents. Fairly Oddparents.
Oh, right. Reference. No, yeah, I remember that.
It reminds me of a hunt. I would probably give season 3 a good solid look.
Yeah, I started with season 3 because that's what was airing when I got into it.
Yeah. God, your eyes are gorgeous.
Thank you.
They're like gray right now.
Yeah, I really... like soft blue eyes that look.
Sorry, sometimes I just get caught up in like people's beauty, like, and I'm just you. Like, I just like, I need to address this. I was like, I'm sorry, stop time. Hold on, 1 second. Okay.
Do you want me to take my glasses off?
Yeah, girl, you're stunning.
I am wearing like pink eyeshadow under my eye. Which
I know, but it's just like, God, I was caught up. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Just talking about beautiful people, and I just look at her eyes. I'm just like, oh my God.
Oh my goodness.
God. Sorry about that.
It's okay.
That was weird. Not that weird, though.
You were enraptured by my eyes.
I was. So do we do bunny kisses now?
No. No, but yeah, so it's, I'm not going to lie, I love Isaac and Evan. They're my boys. They're my kids. The whole boy squad, those are my kids. Those are my boys. And I need you to show you more interactions of the boy squad.
All right.
And Evan. Because it's a good, fun time.
That's all we really care about.
Yeah. That's what I care about.
That's all I really care about now.
Too. But yeah. The first, like, initial launch of this, like, in Scandinavia was, like, huge. It was very well received. But it wasn't until season 3 where it was, like, internationally well received.
Yeah.
And it actually, like, changed things about the website. So they had, like... So there's some baller music.
Yeah,
there's, like... hella baller music in this series.
Yeah.
And so they had, like, you know, like, a license you need for, like, to play any kind of copyrighted music?
Yeah.
But so they had one for, like, their region.
Uh-huh.
And so when all these international people came into the website and started watching clips, they couldn't support that anymore. So, like, the website, you could go on it, but you couldn't watch videos on it anymore.
Oh.
So it became even more difficult for, like, international people to, like, find it.
Yeah.
But, I mean, people still got it out there.
Of course.
I think all of season 4 is on YouTube. For some reason, like, that season was okay, but you can't really find any other seasons on YouTube I don't know if it's still like that. It's been like a year since it ended.
Oh, then it's probably relatively maybe gone. Unless you pull showing Broadway shows on YouTube and they're like definitely not Evan Hansen or DIY Hamilton show about a server in the food industry, aka waitress, et cetera, et cetera, so forth.
Yeah.
Missionaries go to Africa.
Just some fun boys and old Africa.
Yeah.
Okay. But yeah, so it was very well received, season 3. And like I said earlier, season 4 kind of had a hard thing to follow, and also they tried to wrap up like 3 or 4 different storylines in that season. Mm-hmm. Oh, and it was only like 10 episodes.
Oh, that's a lot.
Yeah. So like the longest season was 12 episodes, and I think the shortest season was like 10.
Mm-hmm.
And these are like 25 to 40 minute episodes.
Okay.
So it's not like super long.
No.
Yeah, and I mean, you do have a lot of supplement with the text and the like Instagram pictures.
Yeah.
But like, it wasn't, it just wasn't
well
done. But still like.
Which is super unfortunate.
It's so sad. Poor Sana. I love Sana.
I'm sorry.
But it was still very well received to the point where there's now several adaptions of Skam.
Wow.
In several countries.
Wow.
So the first one was Skam France, which is basically Skam, but in French.
French.
With French actors. That's the one I've seen the most of because it came out first.
Is Skins like what?
No. That's it's like the same idea where
but
it's,
not.
It's not.
Not Skam.
No.
Okay.
No. Then we have Skam Germany, which is called Druck. It's called Druck.
Okay.
We have Skam Italia, so Skam in Italy.
Yeah.
There's another one, but then most recent, as in I found out that the first clip aired today, Skam Austin, as in Austin, Texas.
Texas?
Yes. So we've known for a very long time that they were going to do an American Skam remake.
Oh, okay.
It's headed by Julie Andem, the creator of Skam.
Yeah.
But the first episode aired today, and golly gee, I have to watch it now.
God damn it.
I have to take a look.
All right.
Yeah, I feel like we've wrapped this up. It's very long. You seem very interested.
I am.
Which is funny. I thought this was going to be the one you weren't going to be that interested. Then you'd just be like, that's nice. I'm not going to watch that.
And then you bring in gay children, and I'm just like, ah! Like,
they're
more
than gay children. They're my
boy. I know. You don't bring in gay children. You bring in your
gay
children.
They have to deal with a lot of things.
I know they do. I know they do, honey.
There's a lot of coming to age babe. Stories.
I know. Shh, it's okay. It's okay.
It's okay.
It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Oh, God.
But yeah, there's so many good things about Skam. I love it a lot. Yeah.
All I have to say, if anything, I had no idea that Norway.
Norway. Norga.
Not Norwegia. I had no idea Norway had film. Had a studio. Because it's like, I'm so...
I mean, everywhere does.
Yeah, but it's like we live in OC, so it's like Hollywood. We don't know anything. We're just like, Avengers, take it!
Yeah.
Take it!
I don't know. I've always kind of been interested in international dramas. Mm-hmm. When I was in high school, I used to watch a lot of Chinese dramas and Japanese dramas.
Yeah.
Yeah. I used to listen to, like, German and Japanese music. So I think I also just have... I look into that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So I just have more interest.
Have you ever looked into Danish drama?
No.
Because I have one movie in mind that I've watched... part of, but it has Mads Mikkelsen in it, so bigger name.
I know Mads.
Okay, you know Mads?
I know Mads.
Where do you know Mads from?
Hannibal.
You watch Hannibal?
Huh?
Yeah.
I watched one episode of Hannibal, and was like, this is a really good show, and I should watch it, and then I never watched it again.
Where is it?
It's over here.
I know it is.
But I know Mads.
Okay.
Also, him and his boyfriend, Kojima.
Yes. Okay. I was like, wait, he's married. Oh, wait, no, that. Okay. But, Mads Mikkelsen in it. It's called, I forget what it's called. Long story short, a kindergarten teacher who does not do this crime, but is under charges of, like, sexually molesting one of his students.
Fun.
But it's because the student, the six-year-old, likes the teacher, and he's like, we can't, it's like, child, we can't, this isn't, this is not good. You can't come up and kiss me.
Don't stand so close to me.
Yeah, it's like, you can't kiss me when we're playing a recess or whatever.
Yeah.
But of course, she is a smart little bitch, and she's like, yeah, he touched me. So then, there's a whole, I cannot remember what it's called, I think it's called Hunt, or like, but Yeah, it's from what I saw, but I couldn't watch. I'm just like, I cannot
That's
do
too
this.
Much for me.
I cannot do this. Maybe one day we'll watch it together and just cry together.
No. But that sounds uncomfy.
Yeah.
But yeah.
No. Thank you, Grivas.
Of course.
I'm very interested now.
Yeah. I'm here to bring you random niche things from the internet.
And I'm here to bring you stuff that you'll never observe.
I observe it when you show me.
One day I'm going to show up to your house at midnight. Grivas, you want to watch Bill and Ted?
Heck. Okay, well, I think we're too tired.
We're done.
We're done, so I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope I did an ounce of justice to describing Skam.
Yep. Check us out on Twitter, Tumblr, not so much Facebook.
Maybe soon. We don't do Facebook.
Not really. Maybe sometimes.
I would say mainly look us up on our SoundCloud, our iTunes, and our Twitter. That's where we're most active.
Yep. Links are available somewhere on this page.
Yes.
All right. And
everywhere is Idiots Explain. Specifically, Twitter is @idiots_explain.
If that doesn't work, Idiots Explain Podcast.
Yes.
Yay.
Everywhere. Thank you.
Fantastic. We love you.
Bye-bye.
Nap time. Yay.
I'm dead. I'm done.
We're all dead. Grivas, but your children need you.
My children.